Listen up, guys. This is heartbreaking and absolutely infuriating. It's infuriating. I just came across this video and I had to share it. I wanted to share it, but it is infuriating. So stay tuned, check it out. We'll be right back. So check this out, all right? Check this out. We are going to share this if I can ever get it going. Da, da, da. Here we go. This is a video I found on Twitter, and it's literally going out right now. I don't know what this page is. I didn't research the page, but just listen in. We'll let it speak for itself. This is a state representative literally sharing this publicly. And this is the opinions of the world right now. This is what we're hearing, ladies and gentlemen.
I would encourage the committee to vote no on this amendment for a few reasons. Practical, financial, social, emotional. First, there are a lot of schools that are moving towards gender neutral bathrooms. And if we add female, we might become obsolete very quickly. Second, not all students who menstruate are female. We need to make sure that.
Did you hear that? Hold on. Did you hear that?
We might become obsolete very quickly. Second, not all students who menstruate are female. We need to make sure that.
Not all genders that menstruate are females.
Second, not all students who menstruate are female.
Not all students that menstruate are females. Folks, what are we talking about today?
We need to make sure that all students have access to these products. There are obviously less non-female menstruating students, and therefore their usage will be
non-female menstruating students. This is where our society's at, folks. This is where we're at. I was listening to this. Hold on. I want to go to Romans 1. For the wrath of God is revealed from heaven against all ungodliness and unrighteousness of men who hold the truth in unrighteousness. That is talking about literally a rug laying on the ground and you grabbing a broom and you're just dusting up and you sweep all that dust underneath. And you're hiding it underneath instead of grabbing a dustpan and cleaning up and throwing it in the trash, acknowledging reality. God says that people are doing this. The wrath of God is revealed against these people that are suppressing the truth. Why? Because that which may be known of God is manifest in them, for God has shown it unto them. He's revealed it. It's so clear. We're talking about 2 + 2 = 4, folks. We're not talking about some hard equations here. We're talking about male and female. And this person just said that not all students that are females menstruate. Hold on, let's go back and play this again.
And therefore their usage will be much lower. And that was actually calculated into the cost of this and how much we decided to fund it. And so we do not expect that the non-female menstruating students will use these.
Non-female menstruating students. She says it multiple times. And this is tax dollars, folks. This is tax dollars supporting this stuff.
These products as much as the students using female bathrooms, but it's important to have them there. And that brings me to the social emotional reasons for that. These students who are not female, who menstruate, face a greater stigma and barrier to asking for these products. And so providing them.
No kidding. Are they dealing with psychological and emotional issues? No kidding. And no kidding are they scared to ask for it, because you're talking about saying a man can menstruate and he needs to go ask for the products. I guarantee you, if that man goes to a doctor and says, I need feminine products, the doctor is going to look at him and say, you're a man. You don't need that. You don't menstruate. That's factual evidence. So no wonder they don't know how to ask, because it's foolish. Let's go back to Romans 1. For the invisible things of him from the creation of the world are clearly seen, being understood by the things that are made, even his eternal power and Godhead, so that they are without excuse. Because that when they knew God, they glorified him not as God, neither were thankful. They're not even thankful, folks. The world is not even thankful for how God made them. And they are being told and shoving it down our children's throats while they're developing and figuring out life and trying to figure out if 2 + 2 = 4. And we're supposed to be the ones that tell them, yeah, it's 4. Instead, we're telling them, no, it's pie, or no, it's a piece of pizza. 2 + 2 = a piece of pizza, or it's cat, whatever you feel like 2 + 2 =. They were not thankful, but became vain in their imaginations, and their foolish hearts was darkened. Professing themselves to be wise, they became fools, and they changed the glory of the uncorruptible God into an image made into a corruptible man, unto birds and four-footed beasts and creeping things. Wherefore God also gave them up to the uncleanness through the lusts of their own hearts, to dishonor their own bodies between themselves. I know that God is handing them over to this, but we need to stand up, folks. And we're not fighting against God. He calls us to share the truth here. God is not saying he's handing them over to them and we're supposed to just dust our hands. No, we're supposed to compel and plead with these people, but we need to fight for these children that are being mutilated, absolutely mutilated, because their parents are telling them and the schools are telling them and our tax dollars are telling them that they can do this stuff and put our children in danger by sharing bathrooms with pedophiles and people that are the wrong gender and sharing bathrooms. This is absolutely insane, folks. It's absolutely insane. Who changed the truth of God into a lie and worshiped and served the creature more than the creator, who is blessed forever. Amen. Amen. He is blessed forever. Amen. And we are called to serve him and love him. And we can testify. I look outside. I look out my window and I see the mountains and I see that creation testifies of him. And people are angry at that. People are mad. And how dare you say that those things are absolute? For this cause, God gave them up to their vile affections. For even their women did not change. For even their women did change the natural use into which is against nature. And likewise, also the men, leaving the natural use of the woman, burned in their lust one toward another, men with men, working that which is unseemly. This is unseemly, folks, and the Bible calls it that. This is not our opinion. This is not Christians' opinion. God, the creator who made male and female, get to say what is unseemly, and this is wrong. Men with men, working that which is unseemly, and receiving in themselves that recompense of their error, which was meat. And even as they did not like to retain God in their knowledge, God gave them over to a reprobate mind to do those things which were not convenient. Let's go back to this after reading that.
Providing them in an easily accessible place in all student bathrooms is particularly important for those students.
It's important to these students. Deuteronomy 22:5 says, the woman shall not wear that which pertains unto a man, neither shall a man put on a woman's garment. For all that do so are an abomination to the Lord thy God. This is an abomination, folks. This is an absolute abomination. And we need to be prayerful. We need to be seeking the Lord on this stuff, and we need to be ready to speak. We need to be available, and we need to open our mouths. I just watched this teaching on Vimeo by Steve Deese, and it was a really good video about men speaking up, and we need to do it lovingly. We need to have a concern for these people that are hurting others, but we need to speak up. My wife speaks up more than me, and I am not condemning anyone watching this right now. And she has a conviction for righteousness, and women are standing up more than men, but this woman is hurting people. When I'm watching this video, I can't be quiet anymore. I've got five beautiful girls that are literally endangered by these teachings, and they're hurting friends and family, and they're destroying our children. And they're futile in their thinking, professing themselves to be wise. They became fools. This is foolish talk, folks. And I had to share it. Share this video, like, subscribe, please get it out there. We need to be getting people talking about this stuff, because this is absolute insanity. Absolute insanity. Welcome to the channel. This is Once Lost Ministries. Flynn's not on right now. This was a random video I just wanted to jump on and do. So keep the ministry in prayer and share it with your friends and family. Look forward to talking some more. Maybe we'll do some more videos like this. Until then, we'll see you guys later. Much love in Christ.